This is the history of that genre. Donna Summer's I Feel Love is widely credited as the first song in the electronic genre. It's a mixture between dance and discotheque. Little did she know that she was creating an entirely new subgenre of music that a few years would sweep the nation.
What is love? Baby, don't hurt me. Don't hurt me no more.
But we asked people to name who they could think of when we said name electronic artists.
Nero?
Sub Focus.
Prodigy?
Flat Pavilion.
So, what artists do you listen to frequently in the electronic genre?
Probably Jason Status.
Anybody else?
Nero, Flume.
What would you expect to see in like music videos for those kind of...
Well, it's quite like bassy music, so... I don't know, maybe like a party crowd or something, yeah. Party environment, drinking, dancing. My eyes stop drinking, I hope somebody's dead. When my heart starts beating and my lungs stop breathing in it, I hope somebody cares. When my mind stops thinking and my eyes stop blinking, I know at the end. So, what have you all made this music video?
I thought it was very focused around the culture and what you'd expect from that kind of... Because initially you see someone in a hoodie straight away in like a damp conditions in like a city and it looks kind of like dirty. So you actually think about kind of culture which is like deprived, and then it focuses like around that. There's loads of like guns and stuff as well, and underpasses and things like that, which you associate with kind of gang culture. So that I thought was very focused around the culture and the locations of where they were.
How do you think the video tied in with the song, with what the song, the lyrics were saying, and how the song sounded, its tempo, its beat?
I think they're related quite well.
I think it's a very close fit, sort of,
yeah,
with the song
and the video,
video and the music and the lyrics all fit in very well. And it again shows that culture side of it that is almost random.
I thought it was quite different. Because for those kind of films you expect like a big like, kind of rave, so loads of like lights and loads of quick images, whereas this was quite slow.
So if you were doing this song, how would you film this music video?
I'd make the shots a lot more quicker. Between each.
I think it depends what the lyrics are like, really.
But the whole thing is like it's drum and bass, so it's really fast paced. And so if the you've either got to match it or completely go the other direction, and they went the other direction. But obviously it can work.
I what I would do is obviously if I was to do is keep some videos it is, obviously you said about it's quite an upbeat song, but obviously some of it does slow down. So we'll keep some of the narrative, but also have some more like party aspect.
I would have put Drag Race in there, just for, because Drag Race is a fast-paced and cool. Like car chase, that sort of thing. Like polos going around everywhere.
So you would have imagined that drum and bass song would be a lot faster tempo?
I think it just depends on what the lyrics are like. And
so do you think lyrics are important, or sound is important.
Lyrics, it's more
important,
well, especially in the genre, yeah, the narrative is like the main focus on it. There's no performing as such, it's literally just all narrative.
Well, I hope you all learned something today. I've got a mental rave to go to. See you later.